Beautiful sunlight coming through the trees. Beautiful Sammy walking like a breeze. Where are we going today, Sam?
Shangri-la!
We're going to Shangri-la. Isn't this going to be exciting? And why are we going to do Shangri-la?
Because James didn't know what else to do. Are you filming?
So almost 1 year to the day has gone by since our 4x4 and Desert Tower adventure last year in the US with Sam and Leo. This year we're in Sedona, Arizona, and Sam and I are going off to climb a route called Shangri-La, which is supposed to be the best route around these parts. It's going to be tough to live up to that expectation. From the photos it looks awesome, but the photos I've only seen are of one pitch. And seeing as it's a 5-pitch route, if the rest are crappy, then it's going to be so cool. But I'm pretty hopeful. Sam, are you hopeful?
Full on.
Full on hopeful. He's Swiss, so he's eternally optimistic. We had a small mini epic this morning, where we couldn't find the parking. Finally, we believe we're going in the right direction, but as of yet to be confirmed. We're waiting to find a mysterious, mythical cairn. 10 minutes walk from the car, up some random wash, and the beta is stay in the wash, because if you leave it, you're only gonna find spiky bushes and rattlesnakes. Sam told me not to worry because he'll bite the rattlesnakes' heads off. That's how you deal with rattlesnakes in Switzerland, isn't it?
Yeah.
So we made it. Sammy got us here.
Yeah, shouldn't have drank so many beers yesterday.
We navigated up the lost gully and we found ourselves in Shangri-La. Up there. So the top looks really hard, but apparently they're the two easiest pitches. The crux pitch is that kind of groove that you can see just there. First pitch is going to be a nice stout warm-up, 512A tips. Loads of small gear, except we don't have it.
That's why we brought chains.
Awesome.
Awesome.
Sick, mate. Hey, first billet.
Yoo-hoo.
Sam's about to get ready to go up the second pitch, which is like pretty short endurance layback corner. Supposed to be pretty easy, a bit easier than this first pitch.
I hope so.
First pitch we just came up is this thing here. Don't worry, it's not as nails as it looks. You don't really climb that corner because it's super thin. You kind of go up the corner for a bit, onto the arete where you see that crack, and then back into the corner. Good little warm up. Ready for the next one. What's going on, Sam?
It's a scorpion.
It's a scorpion?
I just came out of the crack.
Fingers crossed there's not many more, because I don't think I can carry him down. He's not called Fat Sam for nothing.
Yeah.
Yay, second pitch.
Woo.
Sammy did the deed and led that one, yeah, despite the traumatic experience of the scorpion.
It's still there.
Still there.
Like,
you were fighting for your life.
Mm.
But being such a brave mountain man.
I like cold mountains.
No mountain. Scorpions. Yeah. So we're here. Here's the business. Going up this thin crack and lay back through a little crook section there, and then up into that stem corner. Apparently it's pretty tough. I'm just hoping there's gonna be no scorpions up there. There's Sam in the third pitch, just about to get into the crazy section. I don't remember the last time I did a climb like that where I felt like I couldn't move my legs because I was so pumped. Might be because we've been doing 2 days of mountain biking.
Yeah.
But it was pretty wild.
2 days of mountain biking and 4 days of drinking.
Don't help.
Not helping.
Getting that lactic acid out your forearms and your legs. But this next section is very beautiful. So we're here in the third belay. which, to be honest, is kind of a bit of a clusterfuck because it's right in the corner and it's really uncomfortable. But Sam, being the Swiss efficient guide that he is, decided to bring along his little seat that he actually found at the base of the crag. And so that's pretty awesome. That was attempt one to get into the corner. Now you've got to go higher. You see there's a slot on the arete?
Yeah.
Yeah, go up to that slot. You can get like decent kind of finger locks in the horizontal slot and then you swing out. Put your right foot on the right wall and swing your left foot out. Get that slot, nice. Just try and lay back off that slot. Lock your right finger, lay back. Put your right foot on the arete and push your left foot behind. High on the arete, as high as you can. Come on. Nice, you got it. Right, now you got to try and move that right foot as high as you can. What are you doing down there?
I'm fucking too small.
So this, I thought, was the hardest bit of the stem, was getting your right foot out of that corner and onto the main face.
Yeah, that's...
Nice, Sam, come on. Come on. You're a genius. It's pretty cool.
That's a super nice pitch.
Yeah. And we are going up there. Still a long way to go. Huh. So here's Sam getting to the top of the fourth pitch? Yeah, fourth pitch. I actually forgot to film at the top of the third pitch.
Why?
Because I'm stupid.
I was crying.
Yeah, he was crying. So, unfortunately, Sam fell off at the bottom, like the first hard move of the crux pitch, and then effectively on-sighted the rest of it. So I was like, well, you should go back, Sam, and do it, considering you basically just did it. And he said, that sounds like a great idea, I will. And he proceeded to go back down and climb the whole pitch until the last move this time, where he decided to fall off.
Fall off again.
So I don't know what's going on, but Sam really likes falling, like in the most strange of places.
For example, here?
Hopefully he won't fall here while I'm only belaying with one hand. But we are now at the top of the fourth pitch, which was a really cool, I think 6C plus. 511C, and the next pitch, 511D with an off width, like, well, not off width, like fist crack at the top.
Yeah.
That's got Sam's name on it. Look at that, he's such a pro.
One hand.
That's how the Swiss mountain guides do it, right there. Woo! Put it there. I'm not really filming you now, Sam. I'm just filming the background because that's what's really amazing here.
I know.
Although I will film you a little bit. You're quite amazing too. Sam Anthamatten, the world's most frustratingly good at everything bastard.
Shut up.
We still haven't figured out what you're not very good at yet, have we?
Golfing.
Golfing? Really? Okay, well, I'm pretty shit at that too, so that doesn't really count. One day I'm going to beat you at something.
Well, tell me where you're not shit.
Where I'm not shit. I'll have to think about that. So, we hiked up this gully, which came up there, which was kind of an adventure. You can just see the magnificent third pitch down there. And we are going up there. Look at that splitter. It's freaking awesome. And that fist crack at the top. This has been a really fun day. Sam just led a pretty wild run out section on this pitch because we didn't bring a friend 3.5 with us. So it was not quite off width, but it was pretty grim. You can see up there the gear that at some point just stops. Good job! He's just got the last roof fist crack to do and then we should be on the top. Looks like another awesome pitch.
Blah 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 blah
blah. Yeah. That's how we
play him on the feet. And the feet. Nice feet, huh?
It's like open hands.
Yeah.
Then a little higher, you can do this jam.
More layback it.
Like a real Euro.
Again.
I can't belay you anymore. I'm filming, so. No, that's fine for you.
Just that part there.
Yeah.
The perfect hand jump.
No, they were big hands. Good job, Sammy. How was that, Sam?
Great road.
Really nice.
Stars.
What are you gonna do if you come across a rattlesnake?
First.
What happens if I've already fallen over and broken my leg and you left me for dead?
I will give you to the rattlesnake.
Oh, you'd come back up to get me to bring me down and feed me to the snakes.
Yeah.
That doesn't seem very efficient. I thought you were supposed to be Swiss.